Hi, this is Joachim for statisticsglobe.com, and in this video I will show you how to drop multiple columns from a data frame using the dplyr package in R. So in this video I'm going to show you an example, and this example is based on the data frame that we can create with lines 2 to 5 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you will see that at the top right of RStudio a new data frame object appears, which is called data. And we can also have a look at this data frame by clicking on the data object, and then you can see that our data consists of 5 rows and 4 columns, x1, x2, x3 and x4. So if we want to use the dplyr package to drop columns of this data frame, then we need to install and load the dplyr package, as you can see in lines 7 and 8 of the code. I have installed the package already, so I'm just going to load it with line 8 of the code. And after running this line of code, we are able to use the functions of the dplyr package. Now, if we want to remove multiple columns from our data frame, then we need to specify the names of these columns that we want to remove. And that is what I'm doing in line 10 of the code. So in this line of code, I'm specifying a vector of character strings that is containing the variable names of the columns that we want to drop. So if you run line 10 of the code, you will see that a new vector object appears at the top right of RStudio, which is called colRemove. And now we can drop these columns by applying the code that you can see in lines 12 and 13. So in these lines of code, I'm specifying a new data frame object in which I will store the reduced data frame. Then I'm specifying the name of our original data frame. Then I'm specifying the pipe operator. And then I'm using the select and the one-off functions to remove the variables with the variable names that are stored in our vector object colRemove. So if you run lines 12 and 13 of the code, you will see that a new data frame object appears at the top right of RStudio, and we can have a look at this data frame by clicking on the data object, and then you can see that our new data frame consists only of the two variables x2 and x4. So in this video, I have shown you how to remove multiple columns from a data frame using the functions of the dplyr package. However, in case you want to learn more on this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on the homepage I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail. I will put a link to this tutorial into the description of the video, and in the description of the video you will also find the R programming code that I have used in this video. Furthermore, if you have liked this video, I would be very happy if you give me thumbs up on the video or if you leave me some positive feedback in the comments. And make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications in future when I'm releasing new videos to the channel. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you next time. Bye bye.